So next video is on by setting out simple circular curves by method of offset from chord produced. It is also called as deflection distance method. In last session we have discussed about offset from long chord. So next we'll discuss about next we'll go through the method of offset from chord produced. So this you can see here the chord will produce to setting out the points on the curve. In long chord, what we have done, that from the long chord we just go on locating the points on curve, so we join the curve. In this method we have to just produce the chord. First we'll starting with this one with the angle delta known here. We'll produce the second chord here. Again we after producing this second chord we'll extend this chord. Okay, we'll extend this chord again. After noting O2 and delta, we'll again next cut the length, we'll produce the chord again. We'll extend this chord. From that chord only itself will again next find out the C3. So we'll go on like this. First, this method is very much useful for long curves and is generally used in highway curves. This is useful for long curves. Then the theodolite is when the theodolite is not available. So when the theodolite is not available, we can go for this method in the case of long curves. Okay. So let here T1A1 is equal to T1A. T1 is this point. T1A1 equal to T1A. That is nothing but C1. The first chord C1. Okay. This is first chord is called a sub chord, and these are the normal chords. Okay. The first chord C1. So here initial sub chord. Okay, initial sub chord. First and last chords are called as sub chords. So this one is initial sub chord, last one is last sub chord, and the intermediate chords are called as normal chords. Okay, so A, B, D, these continuously are the points on the curves. So A, B, D are the points on the curves. Here you can see the curve going like this. Here. This is the curve. Okay, then AB is the second chord. Here AB is the second chord, which is also denoted as C2. Okay, and BD is the third chord, that is equal to C3. So AB equal to C2, BD equal to C3. Next, T1E is the rear tangent. T1E is the rear tangent. And next, A1 T1A from angle A1 T1A is the angle delta, that is deflection angle of first chord. So this one is the deflection angle of first chord, that is A1 T1 angle A1 T1 A, this angle. Okay, next A1 A is the first offset. A1 A is the first offset O1. Okay, next B2 B is the second offset O2. Again same, D2 D is the third offset O3. That's why it is called as offset from chord produced. So when we produce this chord, we'll first take the first offset O1. When we extend this second chord, we'll again mark the offset, second offset O2. Okay, so that's why it is called as offset from chord produced. When this chord is produced, we'll able to mark the second offset. When this will able to produce this chord again, when we'll produce this chord again, we'll able to produce the offset O3. Okay, so now A1A is equal to O1, that is T1A delta. Here A1A, here you can see A1A is equal to O1, that is nothing but T1A delta. Okay, T1A delta, that is length into angle, correct? So this is the first equation, that is offset for first offset equation O1 equal to T1A delta. So since T1V is the tangent at the circle at T1, so from the angle T1OA, from the angle T1OA is equal to 2A T1A. This angle T1OA is equal to 2 into A1 T1A. Okay, right? So next, that is equal to 2 delta. That is equal to 2 delta. So T1A, this T1A is equal to R2 delta. You can define like this also. This T1A you can define this as R2 delta. R is radius, 2 delta is angle. So this T1A is, you can denote it, equate this as R2 delta. So delta equal to you will get T1A by 2R. Thus delta, it will be go like, if it will go on LHS side, it will be become denominator. So delta equal to T1A by 2R, this is the equation 2. Okay, so substituting the value of delta in equation 1, we get, so this value of delta in equation we get what? A1A, that is A1A is O1 equal to, here what is equation 1? T1A delta. Substitute this delta value in this equation, that is T1A into T1A by 2R. Delta value is T1A by 2R. Keep T1A as it is, and in place of delta put T1A by 2R again. So it will be T1A square by 2R. T1A square by 2R. O1 equal to T1A square by 2R. Here T1 is nothing but C1. So you can write it as O1 equal to C1 square by 2R. See here. O1 equal to C1 square by 2R. Right. So O1 equal to, this is the equation, O1 equal to C1 square by 2R. That is equation 3. Okay. As I told, in order to obtain the value of second offset O2 for getting the point on B, for getting the point B on the curve, this, to getting the point B on the curve, draw tangent AB, this one first, draw this tangent AB to the curve A, to cut the ray tangent A dash, to cut the ray tangent A dash, join T1A and prolong it to point B2, join, as I told just now, join this T1A, okay, with the angle, with the angle and offset length, just cut the arc from here, okay, and with the help of angle, just join T1A chord, okay, and after that, prolong this line T1A up to B2, so then such that AB2 here, AB2 is equal to AB, that is equal to C2. AB2 is equal to AB, that is equal to C2. Then O2 equal to B2B, then offset O2 equal to B2B, here B2B is equal to O2. Okay, so you can write this as B2, that is B2B equal to C2 square by 2R. Okay, here what you have written, O1, that is A1A equal to, you have written C1 by 2R, C1 square by 2R. So similarly you can write this B2B, that is O2 equal to C2 square by 2R, correct? So this is your fourth equation, correct? This is your fourth equation. So again same, that is B2A, angle B2AB is equal to angle A1AT1 because of opposite angle. That is opposite angle. B2 angle B2AB equal to angle A1AT1. So since T1A dash and the A dash A are both the tangents, here T1A and T1A, T1A dash and A dash A1 are both the tangents, they are equal in length. Okay, so here A dash T1A equal to delta and B2BA is also equal to delta, as I told now, just the opposite angle. So here B2B equal to AB2 into delta, you can write it at like, as you can write like this also, B2B equal to AB2 into delta, this A B 2 into delta, same like this here, just now explained. This angle and this angle is same, right? So you can write B 2 B equal to A B 2 into delta, this angle, correct? See, right? B 2 B equal to A B 2 into delta. So A B 2 is nothing but here. See that. B 2 B equal to A B into delta. So here A B into delta, right? This is A B into angle delta. So A B is nothing but C 2, right? So you can write it as C 2 into delta, correct? You can write it as C 2 into this angle delta. This angle are same here because you have produced, you have prolonged this chord only. You have prolonged T 1 A chord, and next with you have calculated this angle delta. So that's why this B 2 B equal to A B into angle delta. B 2 B equal to A B, the length of this chord, normal chord into delta, right? So this A B can be written as C 2, correct? This length of this A B can be written as C 2, correct? So C 2 into angle delta, which will give you answer for B 2 B, that is nothing but O 2. Don't get confused. This length of B 2 B is only denoted as O 2, offset 2, correct? So here offset to O 2 you can write as C 2 into angle delta. You can obtain this O 2 as C 2 into angle delta. Okay, then substituting the value of delta from equation 2, from substitute value of equation from 2 here. What is the delta value equation from equation 2? T 1 A by 2R. So substitute that value in here, right? See, B 2 B, that is nothing but O 2 equal to C 2 into value of delta is T 1 A by 2R. So again, T 1 A is which one? T 1 A is C 1, correct? So C 2 C 1 by 2R, correct? You can write like this also, because T 1 A, see, the length of this T 1 A is C 1, correct? C 2 C 1 by 2R. So the arc B 2 B or this O 2, this you can be write it as C 2 into bracket C 1 plus C 2 by 2R. C 1 plus C 2 by 2R, correct? Because here arc B 2 B 2 B is C 2 C 1 by 2R plus C 2 square by R, because as I have explained, a value of this is C, value of this O 1 is C 1 square by 2R, correct? So value of this C 2, the basic value of this AB is C 2 square by 2R, and now we have calculated with respect to this prolonged line, so that is nothing but C 2 C 1 by 2R. So get common, take common C 2 as common. So C 2 into bracket C 1 plus C 2 by 2R. So O 2 equal to C 2 by 2R into bracket C 1 plus C 2. This is the equation 5. O 2 equal to C 2 by 2R into bracket C 1 plus C 2. Okay, don't get confused. Here fourth equation is what? Fourth equation B 2 B is C 2 square by 2R, correct? This is the fourth equation, and again by equating this angle, taking this angle, we got this C 2 into delta. After putting delta value, we got this C 2 C 2 C 1 by 2R. So add these both, that is here this value C 2 square by 2R plus C 2 C 1 by 2R, right? So take common C 2 into bracket C 1 plus C 2 divided by 2R, correct? So similarly, the third offset O 3, that is G 2 D, is O 3 in O 3 equal to C 3 by 2R C 2 plus C 3. Okay, O 3 equal to C 3 by 2R C 2 plus C 3. So the last nth offset will be O n equal to C n by 2R C n minus 1 plus C n. So here will be the previous chord. Okay, previous chord you have to add this. So O n equal to C n plus 2R, that is current chord by 2R into bracket previous chord plus current chord, correct? C n by 2R into bracket C n minus 1 plus C n. Okay, so generally first chord is a sub chord, so that is indicated as small c, and intermediate chords are the normal chords, that is of length capital C. So in case the above formula is reduced to O1, so first chord can be written as O1 equal to small c square by r instead of C1 square by 2r. So you can just write like this also. Okay, O2 equal to capital C by 2r into bracket small c plus capital C, right? So this is also, they are just denoted the signs here. Okay, just remember this basic formula: O2 equal to C2 by 2r into bracket C1 plus C2, O3 equal to C3 by 2r into bracket C2 plus C3. Okay, so but only C1 equal to C1 square by 2r. Okay, we'll go through one problem. So two tangents intersect at a chain is 59 plus 60. So I will tell you how it will tell converted in meter what is meant by 59 plus 60. Okay, two tangents intersect at a chain is 59 plus 60. The deflection angle being 50 degree 30 minutes. Calculate the necessary data for setting out the curve of 15 chains radius to. This is the, they have given the radius in 15 chains. Okay, to connect the two lengths, the two tangents, if it is intended to set out the curve by offset from chord produced, take the peg interval 100 links. Okay, next, length of the chain being 20 meter, that is equal to 100 links. Okay, so now I will tell you how to calculate. So they have first given the chainage PI, point of intersection at here, 59 plus 60. So 59 is the thing, but chain, 60 is the links. 59 chain plus 60 links. Okay, I will tell you how to convert this next, because this one we will, in next step you will get to know this. Okay, deflection angle is given 50 degrees 30 minutes, radius is 15 chains. Okay, so chain being, the length of chain is given, that it's 20 meter, 15 into 20, 300 meter. 300 meter is the radius of curve. Next, peg interval is 100 links. Okay, 100 links is nothing but 20 meter, because 20 meter equal to 100 links they are given. Okay, peg interval is 20 meter, total length of radius is 300 meter. Length of the chain is 20 meter, that is nothing but 100 links, what they are given. 20 meter that is equal to 100 links. Okay, so first we will calculate tangent length T, R tan delta by 2. I have explained this in a previous session. Okay, so R tan delta by 2, R is 15. Whether you put a 300 and calculate in meters, and just calculate in chains, and then you can convert in a meter also. So 15 into tan 50 degree, 50 is 50 degree by 30 minutes, 50 degree 30 minutes by 2. So into 300. Sorry, into 20, that is the length of chain. So you will get here, they are written 15 into 20, that is nothing but 300 into tan 50 degree by 30 minutes, 50 degrees 30 minutes by 2. Delta value is 50 degree 30 minutes by 2. Next, so you will get T value, tangent length 141.48 meter. Length of the curve L, pi r delta by 2, pi into r, 15 into 20. 15 into 20 into delta 50 degree 30 minutes by 180, you will get 264.42 into 20. You have to multiply here into 20 to convert in meter, because 20 meter equal to 20 meter chain you are using. So 15 into 20, R value 300 meter. You can just write 300 or 15 into 20. Next, chainage of PI. See here, chainage PI we have to convert in meter. 15 plus 60 chains they have given, correct? 59 is chain, 60 is links. So 59 into 20, because 20 meter chain is used. So 59 chains into 20 plus 60 into 0.2, that is 0.2 meter equal to 1 link, because 20 meter chain is equal to 100 links. That means one link is 0.2 meter. Okay, so just calculate this, you will get 1192 meter. Deduct the tangent length T. Here, deduct the tangent length T, that is 1192 minus 141.4. You will get the first chainage, that is 1050.52. I will explain how it is. here there is no problem. See, here, yeah, if this is the Chinese, okay, if this is the Chinese PI they have given, okay, 1192, correct? Or just what I'll do, here this is the PI Chinese point of intersection that we have calculated. One, they have given 59 chains plus 60 links, we have converted in 1092 meters, okay, 1192 meters. So this is the length of the, this is the here, that is Chinese of PI. To get here, to get the Chinese point, to get the point of curve point, we have to minus this, we have to deduct this length, tangent length, then only we will get here point, this point. Okay, now we know this point of intersection they have given, that is Chinese of PI. They have given Chinese of PI. We don't know where is the point of T1, where is the point of curve. So for that we have calculated the tangent length here, r tan delta by 2. So we got 141.48 meter. Okay, so from this Chinese, if we deduct the length of this, we will get this value. From this Chinese, if you deduct this length, we'll get this value. That's only idea. See, deduct the tangent length T, 1192 minus 141.48. So you will get 1050.52 meter. This is the Chinese of point of curve. See here, Chinese of PC, point of curve, 1050.52. Add the length of curve L here again to get T2. To get this T2, add this length of curve. 264 you have calculated here, 264.52, that is the Chinese of PT, Chinese of point of tangency. Okay, Chinese of PC, PT, you will get this Chinese of this plus length of curve, you will get Chinese of PT, that is point of tangency. 1050.52 plus 264.42, it will give you 1314.94 meter, that is Chinese of PT. Okay, so the Chinese of each peg will be multiply of 20 meter, because here they have given one chain is 20 meter, correct? So peg interval they have given is 20 meter. Here see, the peg interval is 20 meter, 100 links they have given, that is nothing but 20 meter, correct? So for the Chinese of each peg will be multiple of 20, because peg interval 20 meter. So the length of the first subchord, length of the first subchord is 1060 minus 1050.52. So that will give you Chinese length of first subchord, that is 9.48 meter, and length of last subchord again, that is also 1314.93 minus 1300. Okay, so to make the round up value, as I have explained in previous, that is the normal chords, the intermediate are the normal chords, those will be a same length, but first and last chords are of sub chords, which is having the less length, which is having less short length from the normal chord. That's why they have taken here 1060, that is 10 meter. That is 10 meter greater than this 1050, so that the first length of chord will be first chord length will be 9.48 meter, and next is length of last subchord, that is last, what is the point of tangency here, Chinese point, 1314.94 meter, correct? So to get the round up value, deduct 1300 in that, so you will get last subchord, that is 14.93 meter, 14.93 meter. Okay, this is the last length of last subchord. So number of full chords, that is nothing but the intermediate chords, normal chords, you will get number of full chords 1300 minus 1060, this 1060 is the first chainage you have taken and 1300 is the last subchord chainage. Okay, so 1300 minus 1060 divided by 20, you will get 12 number of subchords. The total number of chords C plus, that is initial chord plus intermediate 12 chords plus last subchord. So 1 plus 12 plus 1, total number of chords will be 14. As I have told, this one is the initial subchord, this one is the last subchord, and these are the intermediates, normal chords, full chords are 12. So total number of chords are 14. So length of first offset is O1 equal to C1 square by 2R, that is C square by 2R. So first offset is 9.48 square by 2 into R is 300, you will get 0.149. Length of second offset, again C by 2R into small c plus C. So C is the 20 meter, that is 20 length of all the intermediate chord is same, that is 20 meter. So 20 by 2 into 300, previous chord here, small c, first chord is 9.48 plus 20, you will get 0.982 meter. This is the offset, second offset. And third offset is nothing but O3, O4, O12. Here what happens, the full chord length, all the full chord are having the same length. So here instead of 20 into bracket 20 plus 20, you can just write 20 square by R. You can just write 20 square by R. That is nothing but C square by R. Okay. So that is what, 20 square by 300, that is 1.33 meter. This is the length of all the normal chords. So again, to find out this is the length of all the offset of all the normal chords. Next, to find out the offset of last chord, that is sub chord, c dash square by 2R, C plus C. So here current chord length is 14.93, last sub chord, previous chord, that is N minus 1 chord, that is O12, is about O13 is about 20 meter, and plus again current chord length, that is 14.93 divided by 2 into 300, you will get O14 is 0.87 meter. Consider, so as I have told, all the normal chords or full chords will be having same length. So you can just use formula C square by R. Okay, so you have to only find out the offset for O1, O2 and O14. Rest all the middle chords will be same. Again, okay, we'll explain this second problem in next session.